let's move on from there to the other big story, our political story of the day. Punjab got its first Dalit Sikh chief minister today. Charanjit Singh Channi took oath today along with two deputies, Sukhjinder Singh Randhawa, OP Soni. But dissent continues in the Congress as some leaders question the fact that Sidhu is to be the face of the Congress in the elections. Is therefore Channi only a stopgap arrangement? Kamaljeet and Anand Patel report.
A historic day in Punjab. A state dominated by Jat Sikhs calling the shots. Got a Dalit Sikh chief minister for the first time.
Aaj Congress party ne ek gareeb nu ethe tak lya ke bitha ditta hai jithe tak meri aur saadi aukaat pehla nahi. Rahul Gandhi ek krantikari neta hai.
Ek chief minister ne meri aas puri kiti hai. Mainu bada maan hai ke Rahul Gandhi ji ne Punjab di is dharti te itihas qayam kita.
But the celebrations in Chandigarh were spoiled by a controversial statement by party's Punjab affairs in charge.
Mukhyamantri mantrimandal ke saath hi sab Pradesh Congress Committee ke netritv mein chunav ladenge.
Former state unit chief Sunil Jakhar, who was denied the CM post by the Sidhu camp, red flagged the statement.
I have raised certain concerns as a congressman, and I'm very happy with the decision of Charanjit Singh Channi ji taking as the chief minister of Punjab.
The BJP and BSP were quick to seize the opportunity and embarrass the grand old party.
इनको वे अन्य विरोधी पार्टियों को भी मुसीबत में ही या फिर मजबूरी में ही दलित वर्ग के लोग केवल इन्हें याद आते हैं. कुछ ही समय के लिए इनको पंजाब का मुख्यमंत्री बनाना तो इससे तो ये लगता है कि ये केवल इनका कोरा चुनावी हथकंडा है.
The change of guard in Punjab Congress has been far from smooth. Even as Charanjit Singh Channi, the Dalit face of Congress party, is at the helm of affairs and in the driving seat just ahead of 2022 polls, what many believe is that Navjot Singh Sidhu is the man who is calling the shots.
The Congress leadership was forced to step in after opposition charges that Channi is just a mask.
Sangathan ke pramukh aur mukhiya Sardar Navjot Singh Sidhu hain. Congress ki sarkar ke mukhiya aur chehre Sardar Charanjit Singh Channi hain. Aur ye dono hamare mitra कांग्रेस के सब नेताओं के साथ मिलकर आखिरी पंक्ति में खड़े हर कार्यकर्ता के साथ मिलकर पंजाब का चुनाव मिलकर लड़ेंगे.
The strife in Punjab unit is not going to end anytime soon. While Captain Amrinder Singh may have been unpopular, the timing of his removal remains questionable. Sources say the entire exercise carried out by the Gandhi siblings was done under pressure from Sidhu to stop him from crossing over to Aam Aadmi Party.
It was far from a smooth operation. Captain Amrinder Singh is in a rebellious mood, and with Sidhu dictating terms, a number of senior leaders have been left disenchanted. They are waiting for an opportunity to settle scores. Punjab remains an unfinished agenda for the Congress Party High Command. With camera person Ashok Banod, this is Anand Patel in New Delhi for India Today.
So has the Congress really pulled off a coup, as is being claimed, by making a Dalit Sikh CM ahead of the elections? Will the new CM only be a mask? Is the real power vesting in Sidhu? Will the humiliation of Amrinder, as he calls it, cost the Congress? Is it too little too late for the Congress to turn the tide in Punjab? Just some of the questions we are raising tonight. Supriya Srinath, the Congress's spokesperson, is with us. Parambar Singh Romana, spokesperson of the Akali Dal, is with us. Hardot Singh Benz is the AAP spokesperson. And Raveen, and I'm also joined by Ramesh Vinayak, one of the senior most journalists in Punjab. Supriya Srinath, first you remove Amrinder Singh in what is being described by Captain as humiliation. Then you struggle to find a successor. Then you put Mr. Channi in place, and now we are told that Channi is only a temporary stopgap arrangement, or that's the impression that Mr. Sidhu will run the show. What's the message the Congress is sending out?
With all due respect to whatever you've said, Rajdeep, I refute each of those allegations. Nobody was shunted out. The MLAs wanted another CLP leader, and the MLAs sent a name. That name was deliberated upon, and Mr. Channi became the chief minister. That's point number one. Point number two, who welcomed his appointment? One of the first few people to welcome that was Captain Amarinder Singh. And I think this is a little known fact that not too many people know. Between 2002 and 2007, when Amarinder Singh was the chief minister, he had handpicked Mr. Channi to be an MLA candidate, just so that everybody knows.
No, that was in the past, ma'am. He did not even attend the swearing in today. No, just a minute, ma'am. You said my question is wrong. The fact is, it was Captain Amarinder Singh who used the word humiliation, said, "I feel humiliated." He hasn't attended today's swearing in ceremony. What's the message?
The message is that the chief minister will have to be someone who the MLAs will trust and stand by. And in this case, the MLAs wanted Mr. Channi to be the chief minister. The reality also is that Mr. Channi heralds the opening up of the doors of social justice in Punjab. This is actually remarkable that for the first time in Punjab's history, and I'm not someone who gives into Dalit conversations a lot or talks about caste, but this is quite remarkable that Dalit is the largest community of Punjab, and it is only for the first time that Punjab has got a Dalit chief minister. As far as the second allegation is concerned, that he is just a stopgap arrangement, absolutely not. We have seen in the past, whether it is the Congress or the BJP or many other parties, the organization and the government together contest elections. We saw Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Advani do it together. We saw Kalyan Singh and Rajnath Singh do it together. We've seen it in the past in our own governments as well. And so this is going to be the coming together of the organization and the government. And that is what we will seek the votes on. Okay. Mr. Captain Singh has done remarkable work. There is no denying that. I am sure Mr. Channi will continue the tradition. He's already taken a very bold step of waiving off the sewerage and the water bills of a large section of population in Punjab. I think that's quite remarkable, and we must welcome that.
Hold on to your thoughts. Parambar Singh Romana, the fact is that after 55 years after the formation of Punjab state, you've got a Dalit Sikh chief minister. That in itself is a major barrier broken. And to an extent, there is a point in what Supriya Srinath says. The largest community, 31 to 32%, finally gets representation. Do you agree, purely in symbolic terms, the Congress has pushed all the other parties on the back foot?
There are two things I would like to say on that. Firstly, I would like to correct the Congress spokesperson. She said that in 2002, when in the captain's first term, he picked him as an MLA himself. Whereas Mr. Channi contested as an independent candidate for the first time in 2007. That's the fact she needs to get right. Anyway, to move forward from that.
I said 2007.
But let's look at today.
As an independent.
Let's look at today.
Let that be. Sorry.
Yes.
Yeah. The issue is, he's the first chief minister of Punjab. But was he the first choice of the Congress? No, he was the last choice of the Congress party. They first went to Jakhad, then to Sukhi Randhawa, then to Sidhu, then to Vikas Soni, and when everything else failed, nothing else worked out, it fell on Channi. And the first statement that comes from the Punjab Affairs in Charge, Harish Rawat, and we all know he doesn't speak for himself, he speaks for the Congress High Command and the Gandhi family. The first statement is that he is not the face of the Congress party for the 2022 polls. The face for the Congress party is going to be Sidhu. So, Mr. Sardesai, you would understand cricketing lingo better. He's basically a night watchman. If the Congress party is serious, like it's talking about empowering Dalits, if it is serious on that, what is the hesitation in declaring him as the chief minister candidate if the Congress wins in 2022?
Let Supriya Srinath respond to that, because you've used the word night watchman. I'm hearing this word being used by the opposition in Punjab, Supriya Srinath, in the last 24 hours, that Channi is a night watchman, that this is tokenism. This is not some dramatic change. You tried various candidates. Even Ambika Soni's name was being mentioned yesterday morning. You eventually land up on Mr. Channi, and he will be chief minister only for the next 5 months, is the charge being made. He's a token candidate, a stopgap.
I first want to express a little bit of a surprise here. I was on previous shows and there the BJP spokespersons were using this word. It looks like the Shiromani Akali Dal and the BJP are still very much hand in glove. They must clarify their position as far as the right to watch man.
One by one.
I did not speak in between.
Go ahead, Ms. Srinath.
The fact is that the Shiromani Akali Dal is in partnership with the BSP. The BSP owes its origin to Hoshiarpur, from where Kanshiram ji was elected for the first time to the Lok Sabha. The BSP very callously says, you know, the deputy chief minister will be a Dalit. Why? Why can you not commit to being to the chief minister being Dalit? The BJP, and I want to say this here in the absence of the BJP, because I don't think there is a spokesperson from there. In the absence of the BJP, I want to ask, there are 17 states where you have government. Why can you not have a Dalit man or a woman be the chief minister of that state? Miss Maya,
they will say they have a Dalit president. They will say they have a Dalit president. The president is a Dalit.
When you have elected, fair point, when you have elected governments, you have the right to make Dalits chief ministers. This government will never do that. This government, Sar Sanchalak of the RSS, will never be a Dalit. You know why? Because they scorn upon communities. Because they believe in oppression. And the reality is, when somebody else does it, instead of congratulating and welcoming Mr. Channi, who comes from very, very humble origins, the entire opposition in Punjab, whether it is the Shiromani Akali Dal or the BSP or the BJP in the center, is trying to ridicule the man and trying to run him down.
Parambal, very quickly, before I go to Ramesh Vinayak.
She is playing a very dangerous game of politics by saying we are trying to ridicule Mr. Channi or the Dalits. Nothing can be further away from truth. The issue is, she's talking about us declaring a Dalit as a deputy chief minister. We've had the guts to do that. We said that our chief minister is going to be Mr. Subir Singh Badal.
Let me respond. You were speaking now. You did, but you can now speak. We've had the guts to do that.
Okay. You have the guts to say that Mr. Channi will be your CM. Have the guts and say it on the program.
Okay, so you're saying that the Congress should announce Mr. Channi as their chief minister should they win?
And which is why I'm saying what I did.
Akalis are saying that he will be your chief minister if you win.
We've had the guts. Rajdeep, we've had the guts to do it. The Shiromani Akali Dal wants to tell the entire community that's the largest representation of the state that we will have a deputy chief minister. Why are you...
Okay.
Why will a Mr... The reality...
Ramesh Vinayak, one minute. Supriya Srinath, answer a direct question. If the Congress wins next year, will Mr. Channi continue as CM or will Navjot Sidhu or a Judge Sikh take over? Give me a straight answer.
Yes.
No, 1 minute. I am asking the question.
I am very thankful to you and to the other panelists on this show. That you're actually acceding and you're accepting that we are going to form the next government, which we will, with a thumping majority. So thank you very much for that, both to the
answer my question,
as well as to the spokesperson who was speaking before me. The reality is that in this instance, I am answering your question. In this instance, it was the MLAs. Sir, please relax. It was the MLAs who decided who the chief minister will be. It will again be the MLAs. I can tell you, however, very certainly, that we have taken a bold step and we will continue to be bold.
Ramesh Vinayak, you've been listening patiently and I'm sorry that you had to sort of wait for so long. I just want to ask, is this a bold step or is this a huge gamble that the Congress has taken?
Rajdeep, I would say that this is a gamble. You know, symbolically, having a Dalit chief minister for the first time is a smart political move. And the Congress wanted to outdo, you know, other parties who have also been eyeing at Dalit vote bank of Punjab. Shromani Akali Dal was the first one to, you know, have a tie-up with Bahujan Samaj Party and also announced that we'll have a deputy chief minister from Dalit community. BJP tried to outdo Akali saying that, you know, we'll have a Dalit chief minister in Punjab. So, you know, in that sense, you know, I think the Congress has taken a calculated gamble by appointing Channi. But the fact that, you know, this Channi's appointment has been overshadowed by this messy transition of power and this after effects of showdown between Sidhu and Amarinder, a better showdown,
you know, Sidhu
will cast a long shadow on Channi's kind of tenure as chief minister.
So Sidhu remains in a way the X factor in all of this. He is the X factor. I'm also the AAP spokesperson is joining me, Harjot Singh Benz. You were a little late. I am sorry because of our we couldn't get a connection. But Mr. Benz, many believe the polls are showing that you might be ahead. But by putting up Channi, has the AAP also gone on the back foot? You will also have to now find a face. We still don't know who the AAP face is. The Congress has got Channi and Sidhu. The Akalis have the Badals and the BSP. Who's your face?
Yes, Rajdeep, before I answer that, I would like to show Congress a mirror. Because we are talking of social justice today. It's a fact that in last 4.5 years, Captain Amarinder Singh and the present Chief Minister, the new Chief Minister, and the two Deputy CMs who were part of his cabinet have miserably failed to fulfill even a single promise. And this is not my accusation as a leader of opposition. This is what their MLAs, their cabinet ministers have been continuously saying, writing letters to the High Command. Few of their MLAs extend to the saying of the Z, we are unable to contest the next elections because people will beat us in the constituency, as not even a single promise has been fulfilled. And now with only 100 days left to the code
Can
of conduct, Congress,
yes.
just let me complete.
Can I please
Congress,
come in?
Congress came, it was clear that Congress is losing this. They came up with this, I'd say a political conspiracy with the people of Punjab. And now the thing is that talking of social justice, it is a fact, thanks to the media, that after a number of names, right from Ambika Soni, Sunil Jakhar, Navjot Singh Sidhu, Sukhi Randhawa, when there was, because they know
is,
that the party
who is your
will,
face,
party,
Mr. Benz? Who is then, your face?
Then because they didn't have any option, they come up with Mr. Channi. And right now,
who is your face?
Party, we are winning. We will announce it. Our convener, national convener, Arvind Kejriwal, has said that our CM face will be from Punjab. He will be a Sikh, and soon in the coming weeks.
My final question is to you, Supriya Sinha. Is this all too little too late? You prevaricated for months. You finally came up with Mr. Channi. Mr. Sidhu's role is still unclear. Many believe he will be the one who is demanding in a way that he eventually become chief minister. It's all a bit of a pig's breakfast, isn't it? In the Congress, couldn't you have done this much earlier if you had to remove your chief minister? Remove him 1 year before an election, not 4 months before.
Rajdeep, with all due respect, I don't think the Congress party is going to be dictated terms by the media. The media was speculating many names. We decided on what our MLAs wanted.
Right.
So just to set the record straight, because I remember somebody else was talking about this, what was happening in the media. I also want to say one very important thing. Captain Singh has done a good job. The MLAs wanted a replacement. The MLAs thought they wanted to contest the election under the leadership of another chief minister and the party president. That's exactly what is going to happen in Punjab. The reality is that AAP has to stop playing second fiddles to the BJP. You are not Team B of the BJP. Please remember that. You were the first to pass the resolution against farmers. You were so quick to do that. Shiromani Akali Dal was sitting on the cabinet which took a decision against the farmers. Punjab ke kisano ko aap dono ki asliyat pata hai, aap dono ko wo aaina dikhayenge.
I have run out of time. We've got much more to discuss on Punjab. It's an intriguing election, but I appreciate that all of you waited even as we had other stories breaking. Punjab politics, lots will play out in the Satluj over the months ahead.